Second chapter, the river valley civilization part 2. In that, we learn about the Mesopotamian civilization. Mesopotamia. What is meant by Mesopotamia? It's a Greek word and it means land between two river. Remember? Students, we learn about the Sumer region and peoples lived there were called as Sumerians. Yes? And we learn about the different types of social classes. And also we learn about the trade and commerce. Today, in this lecture, we'll complete these points. Growth of knowledge, Egypt, the gift of the Nile, Egyptian society, trade and commerce, art and architecture, and hieroglyphic script. So, shall we start? Students, our first point is growth of knowledge. The Mesopotamians made a great contribution in the growth of knowledge. Thousands of clay tablets have been dug out from under the earth. At Tello in Sumeria, there was a big library and having more than 30,000 tablets. The Tello library was perhaps the first library of the world. Students, Mesopotamia civilization ने बहुत बड़ा contribution दिया है growth of knowledge में और thousands of clay tablets वहाँ पर मिले हैं. टेलो में एक बहुत बड़ी लाइब्रेरी है जो दुनिया की फर्स्ट लाइब्रेरी है. इससे हमें ये समझ में आता है कि वो लोग बहुत इंटरेस्टेड थे लिटरेचर में. और एक फेमस इपिक भी लिखा गया था उस समय. उस इपिक का नाम है गिलगमेश. अंडरस्टूड? मेसोपोटामियंस हैड इंटरेस्ट इन मैथमेटिक्स एज वेल. 60 वॉज द important number and their system of counting is called as sexagesimal. The Mesopotamians were quite good in astronomy. What is mean by astronomy? Astronomy is the study of everything in the universe beyond Earth's atmosphere, like sun, moon and planets. So there was an observatory almost in every city. From there they studied the planets and stars and gave names to this. Students, then our next point is Egypt, the gift of the Nile. As you know, Egypt is a large country which is located in the eastern part of the Sahara Desert. And except for the narrow strip of fertile and stretching along the banks of the river Nile, the rest of the country is desert. You having idea about desert? The Nile is the nature's great gift. With the help of the canals, dikes and reservoirs all along the course of the river, Egypt has developed an excellent agriculture. The Nile has also served as a national highway for water. National highway is there. Because of this river, Egypt became the birthplace of the world's oldest civilization. So, Egypt was called the gift of the Nile by the Romans and the Greeks. Students, then our next point is Egyptian society. As we learned in the previous lecture about the Mesopotamian civilization. So, first class was belong to king. King was called as Pharaoh. So in the first class, king and his family. In the second class, priest, noble peoples and the official peoples. Most of the government officials belong to this class and the persons belonging to this class also led a very comfortable life. They were considered close to the king and his family. Student, जैसे कि हमने मेसोपोटामियन सोसाइटी में भी पढ़ा था कि सोसाइटी में फोर क्लास सोसाइटी जो है वो फोर क्लासेस में डिवाइड की गई थी, उसी तरह इजिप्शियन सोसाइटी भी फोर क्लासेस में डिवाइड की गई थी। जैसे कि फर्स्ट क्लास में किंग, जिन्हें पैरो कहा जाता था, उनकी फैमिली आती थी जो एक लग्जेरियस लाइफ जीते थे, और सेकेंड जिसमें प्रिंस, नोबल पीपल्स और ऑफिशियल्स जो पीपल्स थे वो आते थे, एंड इन द थर्ड क्लास फार्मर्स, कल्टिवेटर्स, क्राफ्ट्समैन एंड आर्टिसंस ऑल बिलोंग्स फ्रॉम द थर्ड क्लास, एंड द फोर्थ वन इज स्लेव। ये क्लास हमने मेसोपोटामियन सिविलाइजेशन में भी पढ़ा था। सो मोस्ट ऑफ द स्लेव्स वेयर प्रिजनर्स, दे डिड ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ ऑड जॉब फॉर देयर मास्टर्स टू हूम दे वेयर अटैच, एंड मेजॉरिटी ऑफ दिस पीपल लिव इन मिजरी एंड पॉवर्टी। मोस्ट ऑफ जो लोग थे वो गरीबी में और बहुत ही बुरी तरह की लाइफ जीते थे। ये फ़र्क है इजिप्शियन सोसाइटी और मेसोपोटामियन सोसाइटी में। वहाँ पर स्लेव्स को हार्शली बिहेव नहीं किया जाता था, बट इजिप्शियन सोसाइटी में स्लेव्स की जो कंडीशन थी वो बहुत ही बुरी थी। देन आवर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज ऑक्यूपेशन एंड क्राफ्ट्स। फर्स्ट एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑक्यूपेशन वॉज एग्रीकल्चर। सेम वी लर्न इन द मेसोपोटामियन सिविलाइजेशन, फर्स्ट ऑक्यूपेशन वॉज एग्रीकल्चर, सेकेंड ऑक्यूपेशन वॉज डोमेस्टिकेशन ऑफ एनिमल्स, थर्ड वन क्राफ्ट, आर्टिसंस पीपल्स बिलोंग टू दिस ग्रुप। एग्रीकल्चर, एग्रीकल्चर वॉज द मेन ऑक्यूपेशन ऑफ एंशियंट इजिप्शियन। फॉर इट्स सक्सेस दे हैड टू कंट्रोल द फ्लड वाटर ऑफ द नाइल। द इंजीनियर्स एंड द मैथमेटिशियंस ऑफ इजिप्ट ऑफ दोज डेज द कैनल्स मेड रिजर्वॉयर्स टू स्टोर द वाटर। द मेन क्रॉप दे ग्रीव वेयर वीट, बार्ले, माइलेट एंड कॉटन। And the second occupation was a domestication of animals such as a cow, pig, sheep, donkey, goats, camels, birds, and horse was used by them for drawing the chariots during war and peace. And the last one is crafts like pottery, spinning, weaving, flax, cloth making, glassware, jewelry making, carving, फर्नीचर मेकिंग, बोट बिल्डिंग्स एंड पेपर मेकिंग वेयर क्वाइट वेल डेवलप्ड इन इजिप्ट ऑफ दोज डेज। अंडरस्टूड स्टूडेंट्स, मेसोपोटामियन सिविलाइजेशन में और इजिप्शियन सिविलाइजेशन में या जो भी सिविलाइजेशन आप अभी आप पढ़ने वाले तो उसमें फर्स्ट जो मेन ऑक्यूपेशन आएगा वो एग्रीकल्चर ही आएगा। ये सिमिलैरिटी है, तो ये चीज़ आपने ध्यान में रखनी है। ये फर्स्ट जो है वो एग्रीकल्चर है, मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड द फर्स्ट ऑक्यूपेशन। सेकेंड वन डोमेस्टिकेशन ऑफ एनिमल्स एंड थर्ड वन इज क्राफ्ट। अंडरस्टूड। देन आवर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज ट्रेड एंड कॉमर्स। ट्रेड एंड कॉमर्स वेयर ऑल्सो इन द हैंड्स ऑफ द फैरो। फैरो मीन्स किंग, किंग एंड इज नोबल्स। दे एक्सपोर्टेड क्लोथ, ज्वेलरी एंड glassware and imported gold, ivory, silver and perfumes. Kya export hota tha? To cloth, jewelry aur glassware. Glassware means jo bhi cheeze kaanch se bani hoti hai wo. Okay, aur kya import hota tha? To gold, ivory, silver and perfumes. Understood? Then our next point is religion. The ancient Egyptians worshipped as many as 2,200 gods. Ancient Egyptian जो थे वो 2,200 gods को pray करते थे, worship करते थे, और इनमें से most important है Re, the sun god. He was considered to be the giver of life and then there were also gods of moon and floods. whom they worshipped. Egyptians also worshipped some animals like snake, crocodile. Snake को तो हम आज भी worship करते हैं, पूजा करते हैं ना, जब नागपंचमी आती है तो हम स्नेक की पूजा करते हैं. Each god had his her own temple and a priest. The Egyptians thought that there was a life after death. It means what? They believe in life after death. They believe that both body and soul lived after death. They expected that the dead body of a virtuous man could come back to life again. That's why they took great care to preserve the dead bodies. Such as a preserved dead body is known as mummy. Then our next point is art, architecture and sculpture. The Egyptian had achieved a very high standard in the field of art, architecture and sculptures. So firstly we take information about the pyramids. In your textbook on page number 34, here is a picture of pyramids, and you having idea about pyramids, pyramids की आपको idea है क्योंकि बहुत सारी movies इस civilization पर बनी है और most of बच्चों ने शायद वो देखी भी होगी. So the pyramids, the Egyptian built pyramids. These were the tombs of the royal family. Three pyramids at Gizeh are indeed very important. तीन जो pyramids है वो बहुत important है. The two most spectacular pyramids are those of Pharaoh. दो जो है वो Pharaohs की है, एक जिनका नाम है खूफा और दूसरे हैं खापरे. So there are 30 other pyramids and several other small ones. So these are the tombs. Pyramids क्या है? Tombs है kings की, राजा की. The walls of the pyramids are decorated with beautiful paintings showing battle scenes, hunting and sacrifices being made. Students, then the next one is Sphinx. The Great Sphinx is another astonishing monument in Gizeh near Cairo. It is the structure of mythological animals. The Sphinx, see in this picture, the Sphinx has the head of a man and the body of a lion, and it is curved out of a single stone. ये एक ही single stone में curve किया हुआ है, जिसका जो head है वो man जैसा है और body जो है वो lion जैसी है. The Great Sphinx at Gizeh is 241 feet long and 65 feet high. Understood? Our last point, temples. The ancient Egyptians also built temples. Just now we learn about the gods of Egyptian society. There were 2200 gods. So most of them are on or near the river Nile, particularly near Thebes. Outside these temples there are a huge statue of Pharaoh and the avenue of Sphinx. So three temples in Egypt are very famous, namely the temple of Karnak, the temple of Abu Simbel and the temple of Luxor. Got it? Student, hope you understand this point, art, architecture and sculptures. In that we learn about the pyramids, the Sphinx and the temples. Students, then our last point, hieroglyphic script. The Egyptian also knew the art of writing. Their script is called as hieroglyphic script or the sacred writing. Okay, because it was used by the priest, that's why this writing is called as a sacred writing. Hieroglyphic script was deciphered by Chandulin, who was the great French decipherer. It was a type of picture writing. They drew different types of pictures to express themselves.
Here is a picture in your textbook, picture signs of hieroglyphic script. आप इस पिक्चर में देख सकते हो, है ना, कुछ लिखा नहीं है बट अलग अलग तरह के पिक्चर्स जो है वो यहाँ पर हमें दिखाई देते हैं. तो ये जो स्क्रिप्ट है, स्क्रिप्ट को कहा जाता है हायरोग्राफिक स्क्रिप्ट. गॉट इट? एट फर्स्ट द इजिप्शियंस रोट ऑन स्टोन्स, देन वॉल्स, then they made the paper from the reeds and leaves of a tree. The tree called as papyrus. Papyrus. The present word paper is derived from the papyrus. So writing in Egypt was a special art. Much of the hieroglyphic writing was done very beautifully and artistically. Most important part of Egyptian society. Contribution of the Egyptian civilization. The Egyptian made significant contribution to the growth of knowledge. They developed the solar calendar, which was more accurate than the lunar calendar given by the Babylonians. In order to make pyramids, they made a good use of arithmetic and geometry. They gave to the world the measurements of triangle and rectangle. Then the third one is, they also developed the decimal system of counting and used special signs to represent units, tens, hundreds and thousands and so on. They knew about the chemicals that could preserve the bodies of the dead. Students, here is our point is completed. Egyptian society. In the next lecture, we learn about the Wang Hu civilization. Thank you.